First tonight, a battle over a controversial proposal to invoke a citywide curfew for kids in Tampa. This just months after a shooting in Ybor City killed two people, including one teen, and injured 16 others. And this is Nightside. I'm Dave Wagner. Carolina has the night off. Tonight, community members came together to share their perspectives on that proposal. 10 Tampa Bay's Angelina Solcita was there tonight, where opinions were divided.
Dave, it was a complicated conversation for the community to have with Tampa leaders tonight. This before City Council makes a final decision next week. Now, many are for this curfew being in place, but others say they don't know if this is the answer to the continued violence that the city is seeing, and it needs to be more thought through.
I don't agree with the curfew. We have to start somewhere.
The search to find the right solution isn't easy.
It will take us all working together.
Police Chief Lee Burkaw, one of several leaders working through what a citywide curfew for teens would look like in Tampa. Tonight, aiming to answer questions from the community.
It's intended to be more of a deterrent and educational tool than anything else.
The curfew proposed by Tampa City Council already passed its first reading and would bar kids 16 and under from being out in public places without adult supervision during certain hours, depending on the day of the week. The idea presented days after the deadly Ybor shooting that killed two and injured 16.
My twin was killed in the Ybor City shooting.
Ava Boonstopple, 20-year-old Harrison's sister. She and her parents are for a curfew if it would help prevent violence.
How do we enforce it to have a real meaning, and how would it prevent the Ybor City tragedy?
Right now, the tentative hours for the curfew would be from 11 p.m. to 5 p.m. Sunday through Thursday and 12:01 a.m. to 6 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. If violated, parents and teens would first get a warning, then a $50 fine if the curfew is broken again.
We found in Miami-Dade County, it served primarily as a deterrent effect.
While people took notes on the exemptions and recorded the panel, there were more questions left than answers.
How are we going to implement this?
I just implore City Council not to vote on this Thursday.
Angie, this proposal still needs to pass a second reading scheduled for next week. If it does go through, what are the next steps?
Well, Chief Lee Burkaw actually addressed that tonight, saying that if this is passed, the department will immediately start a policy and training process, both with officers and the community. He also says that they'd like to launch an educational campaign in schools. In Tampa tonight, Angelina Salcido, 10 Tampa Bay.